Revelation 2:21, and I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not.
I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Yeshua has obviously been convicting her, allowing her time, space, to change her mind, repent, of her own fornication, and she has not. The term fornication means breaking or altering the authority structure God has put in place, walking away from God. She is also desiring to submit to gods, or practicing those things such as worshipping and giving themselves to them. This includes sexual immorality that is intertwined in these practices, and some include intercourse with animals.
Revelation 2:22, Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds.
Behold, I will cast her into a bed. Yeshua will cast Jezebel into a bed because even though he has given her time to change her mind, repent, she has not. In other words, she will be bedridden, unable to get out of bed. And them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. If those who commit adultery with her, doing those things she does or literally with her, if they don't repent, Yeshua will cast them into a great personal suffering. For example, they will experience destruction of their bodies, suffer from hunger, etc. Yeshua is telling the messenger this so that he will not be surprised when this happens and will know the reason. Yeshua gives a way of escape. If they change their mind, repent of the deeds and do what is good, then this will not come to pass.
Revelation 2:23, And I will kill her children with death. And all the churches shall know that I am he which searcheth the reins and hearts, and I will give unto every one of you according to your works.
I will kill her children with death. Yeshua will kill her children with death. Some commentaries use Ezekiel 23 to indicate that her children are her spiritual children. It is possible, but it is more likely her actual children, as Jezebel is an actual woman. Yeshua will kill her children with death. With death is known as a plague or pestilence. Those of the Church of Thyatira who are swayed by her will easily identify the judgment of God when they see this uncommon and untimely plague or pestilence that kills her children. Side note, death could also have a spiritual meaning, as death also means separation from God for eternity, true death. Side note 2, some may argue saying, what about the sins of the fathers should not be imputed on their children, thereby the sins of the mother would not be imputed either. Besides the impact of sin from Adam impacting all, it is true that if the children repent and do not follow after the folly of their parents but keep the commandments of God, then they will not receive the punishment from God. Therefore, the children are probably involved in her sin. All churches shall know that I am he which searcheth the reins and hearts, and I will give unto every one of you according to your works. This judgment will be so impactful that all the gatherings, churches, will know that Yeshua searches the kidneys, reins, and the hearts and will give to everyone according to their activities, works, ways. Similar to the early church in Jerusalem where the death of Ananias and Sapphira resulted in great fear upon the church.
Revelation 2:24, But unto you I say, and unto the rest in Thyatira, as many as have not this doctrine, and which have not known the depths of Satan, as they speak, I will put upon you none other burden.
Unto you I say, and unto the rest in Thyatira, as many as have not this doctrine, and which have not known the depths of Satan, as they speak. Now Yeshua is addressing the messenger and the rest in Thyatira. He excludes Jezebel, her children and those who hold to her instruction, for they have been intimate with Satan, known the depths of Satan, by exploring, trying, participating and doing evil practices, then boasting in this fact, as they speak. Side note, similar to the trap Satan has used today through others, how do you know this movie, game or book is evil unless you watched, played or read it? This is a trap Satan sets for the people of God, just like he did in the Garden of Eden. People of God don't need to drink poison to know it is poison. Neither do they need to experience Satan in order to set people free from bondage. All they need is Yeshua. Paul confirms this, yet I would have you wise unto that which is good, and simple concerning evil I will put upon you none other burden. Yeshua will put no other burden on them than to stay away from Jezebel and her teaching.
Revelation 2:25, But that which ye have already hold fast till I come.
That which ye have already hold fast till I come. What they have is listed in Revelation 2:19, they, plural you that is ye, are to hold fast until Yeshua comes. The message of holding on with strength, hold fast, was also given to the disciples and to the messenger of the church in Philadelphia.